saw in the previous video, I went ahead and cut out the templates, and I'm not sure what process other people do, but I wanted to put the whole helmet together to kind of get to make sure that all the pieces fit. And one of the ways that I did that was by using duct tape under tension to conform to the form that I need it to be in. This afternoon, it was under so much tension that some of the duct tape started to come off, started to burst its seams. So what I'm going to do is, you've seen, if you've watched my other videos, you know that E6000, very messy. I had nothing but problems with it. I tried another similar all-purpose type adhesive. Didn't work. Matter of fact, it ended up breaking the tube just trying to squeeze it out. This is what I hope is going to work. Gorilla. Now, Gorilla's not a sponsor. Maybe they should be. But I've had success using Gorilla products on other things before. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to slowly remove the tape. I'm going to prep the surface on both sides of the on both sides of the pieces. Let it sit for 2 minutes. Then I'm going to force them together like I did with the tape. It might be a tedious process, but we'll see. I mean, there's only 6 pieces total, so I'm hoping it won't be too tedious. All right. Of course, I've got my gloves. Seam I'm going to start with is over here. Press these edges together. One is supposed to form pretty quickly. All quite as easy as I anticipated. Well, to say that I'm disappointed is an understatement. This Gorilla Glue does not appear to be strong enough to hold this scene. So, I'm going to have to go with option number two, which I originally planned on, but deferred in favor of this because I thought this would be better. So, yeah. I'm gonna go get the super glue. Okay. So, went ahead, finished sealing up the seams. Had a small mishap here where the corner where these three points joined tore off with the duct tape. I went ahead and super glued it together. It's going to probably take some fondant or putty or something like that. So be careful if you use the duct tape, that there may be edges that don't want to cooperate. You might tear off. Also, these gloves. I think if I had to do it again, I would try it with the nitrile gloves. Although I'm not at all certain that I would have a different outcome. But this this glue ate right through the glove, right, and melted it basically to my thumb. So, yeah. Not sure I'm going to get that off. Feels weird. So just be careful. If you're going to use gloves, obviously you want to use gloves. You can imagine what my fingers would look like if I hadn't used gloves. But try not to actually rub the stuff with the gloves. Okay? We got one more little seam to do right here. And then I'll be done for tonight. So, next time you see this, it'll probably be time for filling in and sanding and things of that nature. So, anyway, I'm going to finish it up, and I'll see you next time.